What if you took the concept of a March Madness bracket, but instead of having people choose their favorite basketball teams, you had them choose their favorite CLI tools? Well, that's what I built out over a couple days, and here's how I did it. The concept was pretty simple. Basically, I wanted you to run a command, MPX CLI bracket challenge, that would allow you to choose your favorite CLI tools over 4 rounds. And in the end, you get to see which tools are most popular. Not just your choice, but how it ranks up against everyone else who's run the challenge. It was a lot of fun to put together, so I thought I'd walk through 5 steps of how I built it, and then 3 lessons I learned in the end. First, I needed to build out the basic CLI interaction. As a web developer, I reached for a TypeScript library for building out CLIs called CLAC. You start by installing it like any other MPM package, and then I listed out 16 popular CLI tools with descriptions for each. Now, the way CLAC works, you can define a group and ask a series of questions and pass along results to the next item. So I declared a group with picks showing different selections. Now, the nice thing about CLAC is you get all the keyboard interactions that you'd expect in a CLI, but you don't have to do any of the work yourself. Now, because each of the selects required both a value and a label, I wrote a little function that would generate those as needed. After each round, I decided to show a list of all those advancing to the next round. Now, like I mentioned, CLAC can pass the results from a previous answer to the next answer, so it's easy to just pick off the winners from the previous picks. Rounds 2, 3, and 4 all work the exact same. Once done, I used a spinner that CLAC gives you while I processed the data. In short, I gathered all the picks into their rounds, and then I looped through the object assigning either 1, 2, 3, or 4 to each of them. 1 means you advanced out of round 1, 2 that you came out of round 2, 3 that you came out of round 3, and 4 you won the entire thing. So that was the basic CLI interaction. But now I need to submit this to a database. As I was building this out, Astro, my favorite JavaScript framework, came out with a database solution called AstroDB in early preview. It's an SQLite distributed database, and I thought it would work really well for something like this. So I initialized a basic Astro site and then added AstroDB with the command astro add db. The DX for working in this is really amazing. You simply add a config file that defines how your table should look, and then you can seed that with a seed file. Astro Studio is their online interface for working with your database. Once you create an account, you can simply log in and then run the astro link command to link the two together. Finally, you can push up your database config using the push command. With the core CLI experience ready and a database ready for me to use, it was time to build out routes. And I needed 2 API routes to be able to interact with this database. I had to be able to write to the database and also read data from it. In Astro, you can enable SSR mode, which means as the routes are hit, it does all the logic server side at that moment. I created a post route and then created a type so I could check the hit to my API to make sure it fit the schema I expected. If any of the provided data didn't match a key or a value option in my type, I could just reject the data. Astro uses the Drizzle ORM to quickly insert things into your SQL database, so I could just use the insert command and then add stuff as I hit that post endpoint. After somebody submits their results, I want to be able to read data from everybody's results and tabulate that for the end user. For that, I needed a get route. Here I would select all the data in my DB table using the Drizzle ORM and then calculate how many points each CLI tool got in an object. Finally, I'd get the total number of the value available and then do some math to return a percentage of the total points won by each tool. That brings us to step number 4, connecting the CLI tool to the actual API endpoints. First, I had to publish the site to Vercel to make sure that these endpoints were live, and then simply post the data to my post endpoint from the CLI tool. Now, for a good UX, I had to give some feedback to the user to let them know what I was doing, and then hit my get endpoint to grab all the processed data so I could return it back to the user. Finally, I would just display it, showing them the ranked tools from 1st to 16th. Time for the last step, publishing the MPM package. I'd never done this before, so I was a little afraid it would take a lot of work, but it was really, really easy. All I had to do was create an account with MPM, log in, and run the MPX publish command. So those are the 5 steps I took to build this tool out. There are 3 main lessons I learned as I went. Number 1, you want to make sure you have clean data so that when you're running all these calculations, you actually know what to expect. With clean data, you know that any calculations you have should return the values you expect. Secondly, AstroDB is such a cool tool to work with. It's got a great DX story, and it's also really quick and easy to learn. The Drizzle ORM makes working with SQL super easy, even though I'm not really a backend developer. Finally, it was really cool to learn how to publish an NPM package, although now I'm a little leery of all these packages on NPM because it's really, really easy to do. I should mention that even though it says it's no longer accepting results, you can actually still run MPX CLI bracket challenge and post your results and see all this in production.